I don't know what Jason was talking about earlier. I've met hundreds of semen analysts. I just met Gray backstage. I mean, I'm not sure, but did he seem a little... I'm kidding, I am one too. This is the diversity showcase, apparently. I don't want to bring the mood down, but I will. Now, I have unfortunate news to report, which was that at the end of the pandemic, my long-term boyfriend, common-law partner, left me to move to the West Coast, which is the first time I've ever been dumped for weather. But it's hard. It's hard when you've lived with somebody for a long time and they leave. Everything reminds you of them. It leaves this giant gaping hole in the middle of your life. Well, two really, but... one of them you can't fill with stranger dick. At least not one at a time. No, I was in bad shape, guys. I was so upset that I wrote a poem. In case the previous joke did not make it clear that I'm a homosexual. People ask what happened, and you know, the pandemic was hard on relationships, right? Any of you experienced that? Yeah. You know, you're locked together in this tiny space, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, sharing a toilet, 15 minutes of outside exercise a day. It's like prison without the sex. And then the trucker convoy came along and said no more lockdown, so I had to let him out. Honestly, I'm surprised it took him that long to leave me, because I was not an ideal partner by any means. Just to give you guys an idea, the first time we had sex, I gave him syphilis. To put it another way, the first time he ever had sex, I gave him syphilis. Guys, don't do this. It's not a good look. Wear a condom if you're having sex with me, apparently.
It's curable.
It is curable. We'll get to that. Honestly, I really don't know how it happened. I'm so careful. I had just been tested. It really must have been a toilet seat. That's what he asked me to call him anyway. So speaking of cures, do you guys, well, obviously you know how they cure syphilis because you were very eager to let everybody know that you're clean now. But for the rest of you who might need to know, I will tell you what happens. You go into public health. Well, I live in Canada, so there you go into public health. Here, I assume it involves $10,000 of medical debt somehow. You go into public health, you sign your name on the little register, you sit in the waiting room. After a while, a very imposing male nurse opens the door to the back a little bit and gives you one of these. So you go up and he takes you by the arm a little too firmly and leads you down the hallway into the exam room, closes the door behind you, locks it for some reason, takes you over to the bench, bends you over, takes down your pants, whips out these two huge 8-inch needles the size of this microphone, and one after the other thrusts them into your ass, pumps in like a liter of thick white fluid, which is exactly how I got syphilis, so I don't know. I think it was the same nurse. Toilet seat, RN. So long story short, I am back on the market now, which is, I know, it's an easy sell. I am back on the market, but it's easier now that I'm older. Like when I was a young person in my teens and early 20s, I just could not get laid to save my life. I know you would never know it now. But it turns out that it was not about me as a person so much, it was about the kind of guys that I was interested in. Because let's just say that pretty 20-year-old gay boys aren't really looking for a boyfriend their own age so much as they're looking for a dad. Who isn't just a little bit disappointed their high school sport was drama club? So it turned out all I had to do was age badly and grow a beard, and then all of a sudden I was having the most sex of my life. It's crazy. This daddy thing really works. I highly recommend it. Ladies, if you're into younger men, grow the beard. It'll change your life, I promise. No joke, I have 3 boys waiting for me right now to pick them up from hockey practice. Now, it's going to be a fun time. We're going to practice some slap shots to the 5-hole. That is a bit of hockey terminology I learned specifically for this joke, in case you hadn't guessed. For those of you not in the know, the five hole is this place in between the goalie's legs. So it's good to be able to put a name to a place where you spend that much time. But honestly, the beard is powerful. It is a powerful thing. Like, 2 weeks after I stopped shaving, I had sex with absolutely the hottest guy I've ever had sex with in my entire life, bar none. Sometimes people applaud for that, but it's fine. No, fuck you. Fuck you. You don't care. He was clearly a meth addict, but he was in the early hot stages of meth addiction. He looked exactly like Timothée Chalamet, except like 6 months into a really serious problem, which is kind of exactly when you want to catch him, right? Because 6 months in, they lost a lot of weight, so they're looking good. They've got that thin sheen of sweat on their forehead like a Dickensian street urchin slowly dying of consumption. And at 6 months, they've still got all the teeth, which is really important because teeth are kind of an all or nothing deal when somebody's sucking your dick for meth. Just kidding, that would be exploitation. He was giving me meth, it was fine. No, in reality, I committed the cardinal sin, which is I went back to my ex, porn. I don't know if you guys are familiar. We were together for 21 years before my relationship. I'm of an age, though, where I started watching porn online before you could watch porn online. You had to, like, look at porn online, right? You would log in with your 28.8K dial-up modem, and a single JPEG would take 20 minutes to download. And it would always start from the top, which was not the part you wanted to see. So you'd have to like go and open a different browser program to do something else, because back then there wasn't even tab browsing yet, and you'd like read the latest chapter of the Harry Potter fan fiction you were following, and then by the time you were done with that, you'd already come, so what was the point of the porn? I don't know. But has anybody ever had the experience of coming across a fetish online you weren't previously aware you had? Stony silence usually indicates yes. No, it's very distressing, right? Because you're going along watching whatever your normal thing is, and all of a sudden you're new kink, and I'm not going to kink shame you, but please do not come up to me after the show and tell me what it is. Unless you're cute and you like to get slapped in the face, then we'll talk. All of a sudden your new kink pops up, you're shocked, you're disgusted, you close the tab, you take a step back, you're breathing heavily, your heart is pounding, but so is your dick. So Control-Shift-T, you bring the tab back up, miracle of the modern internet, and you watch that video all the way through, and maybe you watch it a couple more times, and you start seeking out other videos like it, and then slowly but surely you start working it into your real-life sex life, until all of a sudden, 6 months later, you can't come without beheading a journalist. It's a very difficult situation to be in. All right, thanks, guys. I've been Dan Donnelly.